So we've talked a little bit about load limit. Let's review this just for a second. Okay, so the load limit is defined as N equals the lift divided by the weight. Okay, and of course we had a positive load limit, which is the lift at the positive load limit divided by the weight, the maximum weight. And we had a negative load limit, which is just the same thing, but at the negative load limit. So this N is our load factor. Okay, the positive load limit and the negative load limit are generally different for an aircraft. And so you can think about this as aircraft wings are designed to operate at a positive load limit. So generally they have a higher positive load factor than they do a negative load factor. So positive loads are encountered in flight in like a pull-up maneuver or a turn or anything where you have extra load on the aircraft over the 1G load that it experiences in cruise. The negative load limit happens when you have maybe a pushover maneuver or when you have maybe a hard landing or things like that where you hit the ground and the wings want to deflect downward. And so you can imagine that the positive load limit generally has, the wing is generally designed with more strength at the positive load limit than at the negative load limit. And regulations dictate that structural members of the aircraft have to be designed to withstand a positive load limit of 2.5G, and that generally has a factor of safety added onto it. And at the negative load limit, they have to be designed to withstand only negative 1G, again with a factor of safety generally tacked onto it. Okay, so you can see that these are generally different things. So when we talk about where an aircraft can operate safely, we have to consider both positive and negative load limits. So let's change colors here for a second and talk about what happens at low speeds. So at low speeds, the thing that we're really concerned about is stall. So at low speeds, our load limit, our maximum load limit, is going to be dependent on the maximum lift that our aircraft can get before stall divided by the weight. And that maximum lift depends on the maximum lift coefficient. So this is just 1/2 rho v squared over w over sw times cl max. Okay, we're going to call this equation star. Now we also have to consider what happens if we have too low of lift, because of course, you know, if we look at a lift versus angle of attack plot, we have a linear region, but then there's stall at high angles of attack, but there's also stall at low angles of attack. Okay, so in that case, our minimum load factor would be the minimum lift divided by W, which of course is just 1/2 rho V squared divided by W over SW CL min. Okay, and we're going to call this double star. Okay, so what happens then at high speeds? Well, at higher speeds, we're no longer worried about stall. Instead, generally at higher speeds, we're worried about structural failure. Because at higher speeds, we get higher loads. And so, when we're talking about high speeds, generally the maximum load factor, or Nmax, is going to be dictated by structural requirements. So here's where now we have our positive load limit lift divided by weight, which of course is the same as writing LPLL over W max times W max over W. And we did it this way because now we have this term, which if we go back up, is just the positive load limit, load factor. So NPLL times W max over W. And we can do the same to find N min. So N min is going to be L negative load limit divided by weight, which by the same process, and LL divided by W max times W max divided by W is just N, the negative load limit, times W max over W. Okay, so we're going to label these triple star and four stars. Okay, so now we have here maximum and minimum load factors at low speeds and at high speeds. So how does this look in terms of where the aircraft can operate? For that, I'm going to come down a little bit more. And let's see. Yeah, just for space's sake, I'm going to do this. And we're going to draw a figure here. Okay, so imagine we have this plot here, and here on the x-axis we have airspeed. Pardon the smudge. Airspeed. And we'll start at zero and go up to, I don't know, for this aircraft, say 300. And on the y-axis we have our load factor. So I'm just going to abbreviate that LF. Okay, or N, right? So, and that's going to range from a negative value to some positive value, and we'll say 0 is about right there. This is about negative 2, and this is 5 or so. Okay, so let's imagine this is just for a general aviation aircraft. So the way that we decide where the aircraft can operate is we first put on some boundaries. Okay, and we have boundaries. We have our maximum and minimum boundaries. And you'll notice that at low speeds, our maximum and minimum boundaries are functions of velocity. So if CLmax is known, and we have a design with a fixed wing loading and everything like that, then our Nmax and Nmin are functions of velocity. And they're going to look like this. I'm going to draw them in blue to keep things consistent. But they're going to look something like this. And like this. Okay. So to be clear, this is star. And this is equation double star. And above these regions, this is stall. Okay, so this whole region above the dotted lines, which will kind of color in here, is stall. So you have to operate somewhere in this region here to avoid stall. But once we get to higher speeds, we have to worry about structural limits, which are shown here, triple star and quadruple star. And those actually, because they're just fixed constant values with airspeed, they're going to look something like this. Or let's say that we have a range of negative 2 to 5 or so. So here, these equations are triple star and quadruple star, respectively. Or I guess 4 star is what I said earlier. Okay, and then anywhere above here is structural damage. Okay, so that's anything in this region up here or down here, too. This is also structural. Going to give you structural damage. Now there's one other thing that we need to consider, and that is that there is also a limit to how fast you can fly, and this is what's known as the never exceed velocity, VNE. And this is the velocity at which the dynamic pressure, which the dynamic pressure is 1/2 rho V squared. So the VNE is the velocity above which the dynamic pressure is greater than the strength of the aircraft is rated for. So again, this yellow spot is also denotes structural damage. So that leaves one area here, right here in the middle, where you can operate, and that is what's known as the flight envelope. Okay? So, when we want to pick a maneuver, we have to watch out for these different limits. Star, double star, triple star, quadruple star. Where the blue star and double star are stall limits, the green triple star and quadruple star are structural limits, and then we have a never exceed airspeed, which also is a structural limit. So what's the best place to operate? If we want to do the fastest, tightest maneuver possible, where we would want to operate then is this spot right here, and this is what's known as the maneuver point, or the maneuver velocity. Okay, because here, now we're operating a high load factor, so we're pulling a tight maneuver, and we're doing it as fast as we can before we reach structural damage. So this is an important velocity to know. And the way that we find this is by setting our stall speed, that's star here, so this is an equation, star, equal to the load, the positive load limit, triple star, because you can see that this is the location where those two are equal. So if we do that, I'm going to do this in red to maintain some continuity here. So what we're going to do is we're going to say star equals triple star. And we're going to have 1/2 rho v squared divided by w over sw times cl max equals npll times w max over w. And from this, we can solve for the velocity right here. So this is our maneuver velocity. What you get is Vm equals square root 2 n positive load limit divided by CL max times root W over SW divided by rho. And that's our maneuver velocity. Now, something we can note is that there is something on here that, sorry, I forgot. This is W max. Let me just rewrite this so that it's more clear. W max over SW. Okay? Now that W max is important because we note that there's a velocity here, which is the stall velocity at max gross weight. That's this VSMGW. And that is root 2 over CL max times square root of W max over SW divided by rho. So if we use that, then we can say that the maneuver velocity is just root NPLL times VSMGW, or the stall speed at maximum gross weight. So that's just kind of an interesting to note. The key here is that we know now that we have this envelope that we can operate in, and there's this maneuver velocity at which we can pull a tight maneuver without stalling or having structural damage. So that is the limit to our maneuvering.